What's going on, everybody? This is Dylan. I am the Soccer Program Director at Shanghai Youth Association. And today, I'm going to show you guys how to make your own soccer rebounder for under $60. Let's check it out. To get started, let's make sure you have all the materials, okay? For our wood, you're going to get 1 2x6x8 board. It's going to be around $6. And you're going to get 1 2x4x10. It's also going to be around $6 as well. Now, I highly recommend you get the deck wood that is treated. It's going to be heavier, it's going to have a better surface to knock the ball off of, and it will last a lot longer in your yard. It can get rained on, it will last a very long time. Next, you're going to make sure you have all of the additional material to assemble your soccer rebounder. First, you want to make sure you have 2 fence hinges. These are about 4 to 6 inches. I recommend that you get heavier duty ones. This is going to be $10 to $20 for both of these. This is probably the most expensive component of this, but you want to make sure you get a nice heavier kind because they're going to absorb a lot of the impact. Next to that, you see these. These are just some metal plates that I use. These are going to go into the boards. This is what's going to help it stay in the ground so it doesn't move when you strike the ball off of it. All of these plates, these are between $2 to $4 each, so don't expect to spend a bunch of money on that. And I found this stuff around my house, so in fact, I didn't even have to purchase it. Obviously, you're gonna wanna make sure you have all of your screws to go along with this. A lot of these materials have screws that come along with them, and I also have about 2.5-inch screws as well, and just make sure you have a handful. If you don't have any, that may be an additional $5 to $10. Finally, you wanna make sure you have the right tools to make all this happen. If you buy the board yourself and you want to cut them yourself, make sure you have a circular saw, table saw, or a hand saw. And also, if you don't have those things, Home Depot, Lowe's, and other home good stores will have the ability to cut this stuff for you. The cool thing, guys, is this is all customizable. You can make it bigger, smaller, it's totally up to you. I went with a size that is easy to carry in my car, easy to get around, and also somewhat of a smaller surface to challenge myself when I strike the ball against it. So let's go to step one. Now what you want to do is make sure you have everything measured out correctly. Again, if you have these measurements before you go to the store to have them cut it, make sure you have that. Or just make sure you measure out and cut it. It doesn't have to be 100% even, but it is nice to make it as even as possible. So I cut these to about 3 feet, 3 feet, 3 feet. These are 2 feet, 2 feet, and those are 1 foot each. Okay, again, these sizes are customizable. You can make them whatever size you like. Okay, now that we have everything cut the right way and the correct length, you wanna take your 2 2x6 boards that you cut, 3 feet, and you're gonna take your 2 1-foot 2x4s that you cut, and you're simply going to create a board, and you're simply going to create your rebounder just like this. Good, now that we've done that part, you can flip it up, and this is gonna be the part of the board that we strike the ball against. Now that we have this done, we're gonna move on, we're gonna assemble our legs to this, okay? Now we have this board, which is also your 2x4, that's 3 feet. We're gonna use this to help balance these two boards, and we're gonna put them on just like this using our hinges. So let's do that. This is step two. Good, now that that part's done, you see our hinges are attached. They're fairly straight, nice and easy, they fold down. Now, we're going to install this piece, which is going to be our bracket for these two so they don't wobble around too much. This part is finished. Now this is your support in the back. Now we can flip it forward and we start to see come together just like this. Now that you've got your hinges on, you've got your bracket on the back, now it's time for the last piece of this, and that is to add our metal plates to the board so that when you stick it into turf or into grass, it'll stick and it'll stay there and help again make it stay nice and sturdy when you strike the ball against it. So let's get these installed. All right, guys, here it is, your rebounder. It is adjustable any angle. Last thing we're gonna do to make it easy to transfer, we're gonna take our handle and we are going to screw this right here on top. Boom. There you have it, guys. Let's go test it out.
Thanks for watching, guys.